Hi there, this is Abhishek, and in this video I will talk about one of the functions of dplyr package, which is one of the very useful package in R for transforming your data into information. Hi there, this is Abhishek, and in this video I will talk about a very quick feature of dplyr, which is distinct feature, and as the name suggests, it helps us identifying the distinct values from the database fields or data frame field. So distinct, as you must be aware, it is a very resource intensive function, but within the dplyr it helps us doing the it helps us knowing the distinct values very quickly. So let's see how it works in action. But before I move ahead, just a quick information request that if you want all of this information directly in your inbox about whenever I'm uploading my video, then go ahead and subscribe to this channel, which is R Video Tutorial, and get all of this information directly in your inbox. So let's go ahead and use this feature. And first of all, get the library, which is dplyr, and once you get it, let's evaluate one of the internal data set, which is empty cars. So I will just say str and empty cars, and here are my empty cars details. So as you can see, am, it has a variable am, it has a variable which is wt, I think weight, and hp is horsepower. So let's see how many unique value that you have in the horsepower. So for that we will use the function which is distinct related to the dplyr, and we will first specify the dataset name, and then we specify the HP, which is a variable in it. So here are the distinct values which are there in the empty cars for HP field. Similarly, if we have any other information or any other variable like empty cars AM, it should show only 1 and 0, whether it car is automatic or manual. If you want to know more about it, you can put a question mark and see if a distinct, and it will show you a lot of information about how you want to, you know, get the data. So it has different parameters like .keep_all, dots, and a sample about how you can use this, a sample example that you can get it. And one of the interesting things which I have seen in the example is the applying the distinct feature on the, or distinct function on the calculated columns like this, where it is finding the difference and only getting the distinct difference. So that's an interesting thing that you can get it, and whenever you have such requirement. So that's quickly I wanted to talk about the distinct function, and I'll meet you in the new video with a new topic.